Toenail fungus, otherwise known as onychomycosis or tinea unguium, is a pretty common fungal overgrowth of the toenail. They'll enter through the small cracks in your nail or the nearby skin and start growing in their new home, your toenail. And this can happen on just one nail or several of them. And in this video, I'm going to share with you what the fungus is, what causes it, and a three-step method to fix it, so stay with me till the end. I'll also provide timestamps down below to help you find the information even faster. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Let's start off with what it is. So fungi thrive in warm and moist environments, which lets them to naturally overpopulate. The same fungi that causes jock itch, athlete's foot, and ringworm can also cause nail infections, and they are far more common on the toenails than your fingernails because your toes are in shoes where it can get warm and moist. And yes, they can spread from someone else's toes to your toes, so next time you're getting that pedicure, ask them how they disinfect their tools and how often they do it. Emery boards and nail clippers are an easy way that they could spread, and they look like this. Let's take a closer look. The nail starts to become distorted and may lift off from the nail bed. It will start stinking pretty bad, and as far as distal subungual infections go, you'll get the classic white and or yellow streaks across the nail. Sometimes your doctor may want to even verify that by scraping it and sending it off to a lab, just to make sure it's not something like lichen planus or psoriasis. And sometimes there's another condition called yellow nail syndrome. So this is good to just rule those out to make sure that you actually do have a nail fungi. And there are some people who are at more risk than others to develop toenail fungal growths. For example, if you have lower blood circulation in your toes, which happens naturally with aging, if you sweat a lot, if you work in an area that's humid or moist, if you walk barefoot in public places like that are damp, like swimming pools and gym showers, and if you're either a figure skater, ice hockey player, or a speed skater, you're said to be more prone to them, and this is just because of that tight footwear issues and doing activities with repeated exercises with an emphasis on your toes can cause these fungal overgrowths. Now that we learn what it is, what it looks like, and who it actually affects more, let's take a look at these three steps to help combat it. And one important thing to note is that they don't typically go away on their own. Currently, it affects 1 in 10 people worldwide, with more than half of these ages 70 and up. So they do need to be addressed, and the sooner, the better. And these solutions will really depend on the severity of it and the type of fungus causing it, which can take months to see results, so please be patient. So with that said, the first is to try the Kerasal Nail Renewal Solution, which I linked down below, that I like. Helps reduce the discoloration and the thickness while exfoliating. A lot of that is thanks to the urea and the lactic acid. Go ahead and apply a thin layer 2 times per day for the first week of use, once in the morning and once at night. And after the first week, do it just at night for a minimum of 8 weeks total. While applying the urea, a trick is to cover it with a watertight bandage or an occlusion dressing, which helps ensure that the urea penetrates the nail and doesn't rub off. And you should actually start seeing a difference as little as 2 days, so that's great. Secondly, you can try Lamisil Cream, which has terbinafine. Right after a shower is a good time to use it, but one thing I will have to point out is that these OTC products treat the fungus on the skin around the nail bed and not the actual nail fungus itself.
Hey, it's me, Digger, the athlete's foot fungus. You know what I love about the beach? Plenty of bare feet. All we need is some wet ground and you could be itching and burning in no time.
Get Lamisil AT, the only gel with a powerful active ingredient that stays in the skin until the fungus is gone.
They target the nail's appearance, but the actual fungus might still thrive, requiring prescription medicines, which you either take by the mouth like fluconazole or apply to the nail as a nail polish like Penlac. The third method you could try is using Vicks VapoRub. As we have a pilot study back in 2011 that looked at this, actually found that Vicks VapoRub seemed to have some clinical effect in treating onychomycosis, particularly when C. parapsilosis and T. mentagraphites were the infecting organisms. And you could do this once a day, either in the morning and night, and wear socks after, which can help with absorption. And remember, these methods will take months and even up to a year sometimes. And if none of these end up working, you may have to speak to your dermatologist if you have a severe case, as they may recommend removing the nail or provide a laser treatment that is said to help as well. Sometimes debriding the nail to thin the area out to allow for deeper entry of the products can help as well. A podiatrist can target this even better. You'll also have other methods that are not scientific, but has helped some, like using mouthwash, snake root extract, and oregano oil. And arguably one of the best things that you can do is to focus on ways to stop it from recurring or spreading. The first is avoid being barefoot in public places, drying your feet well after showering, reducing your use of artificial nails, alternating your shoes, and sprinkling antifungal powder in them. And one thing that I feel like everyone forgets to do, which is sanitizing your nail clippers and never sharing them with anyone. It's probably one of the easiest ways to spread it from person to person. And finally, once it's all gone, keep your toenails dry, clean, and well trimmed. This will go a long way. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on toenail fungus? Leave them in the comments below. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.